Hey, what up, y'all? It's your boy Marley Marv. Welcome to my channel. Please do me a favor and hit that like and subscribe button. Hit that like and subscribe button, please. I just want to thank y'all for taking the time to even view whoever's gonna come by this video and just stop in and give me a view. That I appreciate it. I'm just someone that been through a lot in my life. Like, I've been through a lot. I experienced a lot of downs more than ups. I had my ups, but it was a lot more downs than ups. And a lot of, like, my past, a lot of stuff from my childhood, from drug abuse to prisons to sleeping with mad different women to just having really no care in the world, until one day my life has been just completely changed. And I'm not gonna sit here and take the credit, y'all. I'm thinking that I did this on my own. I did not get here by myself. It wasn't strictly my will. It was only because of the grace of God that I sit here today. So I always got to give him credit where it's due, because you're looking at a changed man, not because of anything that I did, but because of his grace and mercy. But a little bit about me, man. I'm 35. I had a rough childhood. I didn't know how to cope with a lot of things from my childhood, which led to drug abuse. So not knowing how to cope with life led to me just using drugs. I didn't have to think. I didn't have to feel. I hung out with the homies. I stayed out on the streets a lot. And you know, it's funny because I have a special spot in my heart too for people that still live like the street life, people out there with the guns and the gang members and stuff. Because when you see them, you know, yeah, you're like, wow, man, these dudes is brutal. But honestly, what had me out on the streets is that's where a lot of pain is. Most of the people that you see out there that are living that life, some of them may have no choice. Some of them been through a lot, to where like your heart gets hard. Like, when you grow up and you got your family members not promoting any hope in your life, they're using drugs or whatever the case may be, and all you know is the fight, depending on some of the environments you're in, fighting, hustling, like overtime, all that good stuff that you wanted to do, that policeman you wanted to be, that goes out the window. You just have a hard heart. So like, I have a passion for like people that are on the streets, because they don't see, their eyes ain't open yet. And I know God put me in a place to be a voice for people that are still on the streets. I don't act like I'm better than no one. I'm not on this channel to beat nobody down or try to big me up. I'm on this channel to promote hope. That's all I ever want to do, is to promote hope and to let people know that, listen, if I can do it, you can do it. Like, I wish you knew me sort of personally, or you could talk to some people that know me. They could be like, Marv didn't just change his life. He's like a completely different person. Like, it wasn't just a 180, 360, like completely different. And again, it goes to God. But we'll get in, as my channel grows and as we go, I'll get in more and unravel more about who I am, what I've really been through, and things of that nature. But tonight I want to talk about believing in yourself. And this actually came up. I was hanging with my daughters earlier, and we have like this karaoke machine, and I'm playing on the platform. We're acting like we're rapping and stuff. And I'm like, hey, you got anything to say? And she's like, yeah, I wanna. She's, mind you, she's 10. She's like, I wanna talk about believing in yourself. And she got her little thing, so she's to get up there. And I'm sitting here tonight, I'm like, man, I'm gonna talk about believing in yourself. Because honestly, I never believed in myself. Never. I believed, when it came to like believing in myself, it wasn't positive stuff. Like, it was more like I believed I could hustle. I believed I could do wrong. I believed that. But when it came to like me getting a job where I can maintain it, nah, I don't believe I could do that. Or me being in a relationship where I could be like loyal to one, nah, I don't think I could do that. And so I never really believed in myself on a positive note. I believed on myself on a negative note. But believing in yourself is real important, y'all. And there's a lot of people out there I know who is having a hard time believing in yourself, whether it be from your environment you're in, whether it be from the lack of love we're getting from our parents or just other people, or whether it just be your own self-doubt. It happens. But believing in yourself is key, because once you start to believe in yourself, once you start to love yourself, you'll start producing better habits. You'll start making better decisions. A lot of decisions that I made, poor choices and things that I ended up doing, was because of my lack of belief in myself and my lack of love for myself. I told you, I only believed in myself when it came to doing wrong, you know? So now that I'm doing right, I'm like, wow. And guys and girls, this is not easy. Yo, life is not easy. Like, there's always, I feel like I'm always in the boxing ring. I just got over something over here. And then it's like, oof, all right. But now it's like, man, now there's a new battle fighting. Like, ever since I got my life together and God has really opened my eyes, it's like I'm seeing things I never seen, but I'm fighting battles I didn't even know were in my life when I was just messed up. Like, it's tough. But I believe in me today. Like, I believe in me today, and because God believed in me. He believed in me first, and then from his belief in me makes me believe in me. And then from his belief in me to make me believe in me makes me to believe in you. So, like, if we just rotate this believing in each other and rotate the love, that I feel that can start to make somewhat of a difference. No, not a big difference. I know things that are going on in the world today is, like, out of control, and some of it looks like we ain't making an impact. But at the end of the day, if there's something I can do on my end, I can't speak for the 1,000 other guys or who's doing what. All I can do is speak for me. I want to try and just believe or make a little difference in my area, you know. But believing in yourself, again, it's key. It's really key. And I wish I had better role models to show me, like, a better way to teach me better. But I don't blame them. I can't blame anyone. I take accountability for my own actions. But I know today I believe in me and I can make better decisions and I could be at a better place in my life today. As you can see, this is my shirt. It's called Growth is Infinite. And I got the hat right here because coming where I come from, it's really like, this is really growth is infinite. Like, it's really like coming from, like, my mom in drug addiction and seeing some of the things hurt her that hurt me, and living in Baltimore to back and forth to Philly and other places like that. It took a toll on me. And for me to be where I'm at, statistically, I'm supposed to be, I went to prison for 4.5 years. So statistically, I'm not supposed to really be where I'm at today, statistically, you know? But in the eyes of God, I'm right where exactly I'm supposed to be. So I'm grateful for that. And I'm just here to promote hope, y'all. I hope y'all continue to follow and we grow together and we spread hope together. And if there's anything that you guys may wanna talk about or bring up, bring it up. Let's talk about these things. Because as a man and coming from the street, we're taught certain codes, like, I'm not supposed to express my feelings. If we get angry, you just punch somebody in the face. Like, we don't know how to have a disagreement without fighting. And it was, the code's wrong. The code that's out in the streets right now is wrong. Like, and I'm here to, like, come against that code. But the thorough today, like, what's thorough is going to work every day, taking care of my family. Anyone can go sell drugs. Anyone can do that. And again, I'm not against people. I have homies right now that are still out living that life, that are doing things like that. And I'm not beating them down or trying to beat them down. Some people are stuck in that. But we have the wrong image of what thorough is. That does not make us thorough because you have a 357 on your hip or because you sold drugs all day. That's not thorough at the end of the day. That's what society tries to paint. That's what some environments, but that's not thorough. You know, being home at a Friday night and about to make cookies with my kids, that's thorough to me. You know what I'm saying? Making sure that the bills is paid when really I live the lifestyle going out on a regular basis, but I'm like, nah, you know what? I got to pay the bills. That's thorough to me. So, like, my whole view of life is turning now, and I'm learning as I go. Learning as I go. You know what I mean? Coming home, being on parole, the prison time, like the stuff from my childhood, learning how to communicate. Like, I'm learning a whole bunch of new stuff. But it's okay though, because I want to learn today. I want to be better. But I'm not gonna, I don't want to hijack y'all time or try to prolong it. As this grows, we could get into more details. I could talk to you more about what's going on in my life, man. And I want us to grow together. So I appreciate y'all, everything y'all do. I pray y'all stay safe. Don't give up on your faith, wherever you may be at. Don't give up. God's there. It may not seem like it. And y'all have a great night, man. And I'll see y'all next time.